Okay, so when did you first get involved with martial arts?
I started martial arts in 1992.
Under what circumstances?
Well, I was 15 and Bruce Lee was the idol, right? So basically started because of Bruce Lee.
And you were 15, were you getting into fights? You were in high school.
No, I wasn't getting into fights. I was not the fighter type. You know, I remember watching fights in high school, and I remember watching a fight where the guy did not do very good, and you could tell he didn't know how to fight. And I remember thinking, man, if I ever get into a fight, do I really want to look like that guy? And so I thought, well, you know, I might as well start trying to learn some martial arts. And loving Bruce Lee, you know, I'm searching out the kind of martial arts that he did. And so basically just started with that. I found a place in town in Eugene that did the same philosophy as his teachings, and I just kind of started there at 15, 1992.
And then from there, where did it progress? This is 92, and then did you stick with that or did you move on?
So I stayed with that, and then I introduced a couple other arts to it. You know, when we're training, then I started learning the Jiu Jitsu with it and the Filipino martial arts. Stayed in Eugene, kept teaching, and then my first instructor, Terry Grant, ended up leaving Eugene. And so there was a handful of us that got together just to kind of keep it alive in Eugene. So there was a lot of backyard training there for a while, training wherever we could. And then 1997, we started teaching out of another karate school that had some available time for us to get together and train, so we rented out space from them. And then in 1997, I moved to California to start teaching. And actually in 1995, I started teaching with a training partner of mine at the University of Oregon from 1995 till when I left California in 1997. So I was there for a couple of years. That had a big influence in my teaching.
And at one point you met Hickson Gracie, correct?
Yeah, so Hickson Gracie we used to bring up to Eugene, Oregon. This was before the UFC tournaments and before everyone really knew about the Gracie name. And first time he came up, I don't know, maybe it was 1991 or 1990, when was it? Maybe it was 93. Maybe the second time he came up was 1993, before the UFC. And there was probably maybe 40 people at the seminar, not very many, for what would be known as the Gracies later. 40 people at a seminar at that time was nothing compared to now. And I remember we had posters up in the gym that said coming event was the UFC, and it had like karate versus judo and judo versus kung fu and the whole thing. It was the first poster of the UFC. And Hoyce Gracie was on the cover of the poster. And I asked Hickson, I said, are you going to do this? And he says, no, that's my brother. I'm going to do, his brother was going to do it. And so I remember thinking, oh, that's cool. And actually, you know what? He wasn't on the cover because I asked him if he was going to do it. But very cool experience. Pretty a big highlight for me to be able to train with the Gracies before the world knew who they were. That moment will never come again. You know, training with Hickson Gracie in a small academy with only 40 people or so. Got to roll with them and train with them. And we didn't know what we had on our hands at that time at all. Nobody knew what was going to happen with this whole thing. He was just another guy. In fact, I remember seeing the flyer inside the gym that said, upcoming event flyer for Hickson Gracie doing a seminar there. And I remember asking my instructor, Terry, at the time, if I should go. And he said, yeah, you don't want to miss this one, man. This guy's becoming one of the best guys on the planet. Because I had to ask for the money to go from my parents because I wasn't working or anything. So it was kind of a big deal to come up with, like, I think it was like $80 for 2 days for the seminar. But I'm glad I did because it changed my life. Pretty crazy.
Oh, that's awesome. So, you know, when you say you didn't know what you had on your hands, was Hickson, I mean, was Hickson just not known in the U.S., or was he, did he have, I mean, were the Gracies known better in other parts of the world, and just the U.S. was kind of...
Yeah, I think, you know, in Brazil, the Gracie family has been pretty big. I mean, I think most of them know who they are because of Elio Gracie, and, you know, there's several of them between cousins and relatives and that sort of thing. So it's a pretty big, well-known name in Brazil. The Gracie family moved up to the United States in mid-80s, late-80s, and was just training out of the garage and just trying to get their name out to show how people to show people how effective their art was. And so they came up with some videos, Gracie's in action, trying to promote what they were doing. And actually, they came out with the UFC. Originally, Horian put together the UFC, and it was kind of the platform for showing everyone how effective the art was. And then from there on, it just kind of spread.
Right.
So in the United States, nobody knew who they were up until that time. In fact, the next time Hickson came up to do a seminar for us, maybe in 1994, 95, somewhere in there, I think maybe it was over 200 people that showed. Because from the first seminar of 40 people to the second one, the UFC had hit and Hoist was kind of the big scene. And all of a sudden everybody wanted to train, you know. And I think it might have been right around 200 people or something. It was a big seminar, it was a huge seminar. We had to have it in a high school gymnasium. It was a lot of people.
So were you able to find adequate training partners and teachers at that point, or was the scene still pretty small?
Yeah, it was really small. You know, at that time, it was just kind of the group of us that had been doing the seminar together, getting together to kind of review what we'd learned. Nobody in the area was doing jiu-jitsu. Nobody in the state of Oregon really was doing any jiu-jitsu because it was just so new. You couldn't find it anywhere. And when we first started, you know, we were wearing, you know, our jeans or our shorts or a t-shirt. There really was no gi yet. It was really rudimentary, just people getting together and just kind of reviewing what we learned at the seminar and just kind of the blind leading the blind, really. Until around 1995, then we got introduced to Megaton. He came up to do a seminar in Albany and just destroyed everybody. he was just doing jiu-jitsu on everybody and just making everybody tap, and he was just phenomenal, unbelievable. You know, and here's a guy that's 145 pounds or 150 pounds just trashing everybody, you know, with jiu-jitsu. And so we got linked up with him and just stayed with him, been with him ever since, pretty much, you know. He was also tied in with Paul Vunak and Tom Cruise, the two guys that I had learned my Jeet Kune Do and the Filipino martial arts stuff from in the mid-90s. And so they already knew who Megaton was. Paul Vunak owned a company called Progressive Fighting Systems, and Megaton was already helping that company out a little bit, like kind of cross-training with the JKD Kali guys. They were learning a little bit of jiu-jitsu, that sort of thing. So that's how we got in with Megaton, was through Paul and Tom, you know.
Right, and you still have a relationship with Megaton.
I do.
At this point, right?
Yep.
And so is he sort of, I mean, you have a relationship with the Gracie family. You teach Gracie Jiu-Jitsu, is that correct?
Technically, I don't, because the term Gracie Jiu-Jitsu now is copyrighted, so
right.
You have to be. But I originally learned through Hickson and just through his seminars. And mm-hmm. I went to his school in Pacific Palisades a few times and just kind of randomly. But most all of it's from Megaton. Because like I said, kind of the blind leading the blind from, you know, that time period of 92 to 95 was just really kind of Hickson Gracie seminars and not really knowing what was going on, and until Megaton came around and really kind of got us more dialed in with it. And Megaton is one of Hickson's black belts. He was part of the Gracie lineage. So lineage-wise, it comes from Gracie Humaita, which is a school in Brazil that Hickson and Hoyler and all those came from. And Megaton's from that school, so I'm kind of from that lineage. But I don't claim to teach Gracie Jiu-Jitsu because
right.
it's something a little bit different. You know, I just, you know,
It's licensed. It's something to do with licensure.
Yeah, and yeah. You know, I can't be saying I do Gracie Jiu Jitsu.
Sure.
You know, so.
Sure. Reasonable. So, but you still work with Megaton. Is he sort of the? Is he holding that lineage? I mean, what is the deal with lineage in martial arts at this point? I mean, is there a? Do you have a master and then an intermediary between the master and the general student population? Because the master may not be accessible.
Well, it shifts and it changes based on politics and egos and personalities.
And licensure, right? Probably.
Right. And it does. And Hickson, or excuse me, Megaton still waves Gracie Humayato's flag, you know, for sure. That's his lineage. And I still wave, you know, Megaton's flag. And then above that, the Gracie Humayato flag. You know, there's lineage-wise, everybody eventually kind of breaks off. Like, if you look at the school of Gracie Humayato out of Brazil, okay, it's just one school. I've been there. My gym's bigger than it. It's not a very big place, right? But you think about how many people have come out of that gym and kind of started a name for themselves. So you have, like Salo Ribeiro came from Gracie Humayato. You have Hickson that's out of there. You have Hoyler that's out of there. You have, you know, several different, Pedro Sauer is out of there. Megaton is out of there. So they all eventually kind of support Gracie Humayato, but they're not Gracie Humayato schools around the country. You know what I'm saying? They've kind of started their own name. So it's kind of branches off of that, but it kind of goes back to the Gracie family and Gracie Humayato.